there is a responsibility that is attached to the prayer you are praying today. There is a responsibility that is attached to the miracle you are praying today. There is a responsibility that is attached, praise the name of God, to what you are expecting God to do for you. Because relationships are always built on what you said, praise the name of God. You said you will respect me. You said you will never beat me again. You said you will buy a car for me. You said you will love my people. You said you will do this and this to me. That is how the relationships are built. Relationships are built by what she said and what you said. And that's why sometimes, every time there is a problem between two people who love themselves, the lady will be like, you said you will never beat me again. Look now, you have beaten me. Praise the name of God. The lady is using what the man said to remind the man the foundation upon which the relationship was laid upon. You said you will never do this to me. You said you will never behave this way. How are you now behaving this way? I feel the God. I feel God in this place. I don't know about you. Praise the name of God. You know, sometimes when you are talking to God, it's always good to talk to God on the account of what God said. He said, no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. It is God who said, you will always be the head and not the tail. It is God who said, he is your shepherd. And God, if you be my shepherd, why am I in wonder again? For it is through the relationship that God invites us into the prayer. Do you know if there is no relationship between you and God, you will not have the opportunity of the prayer? You can pray because there is a relationship between you and God. And now Abraham is brought into the responsibility of prayer without his knowledge. When God invites us into the inner chambers, now you can ask him anything you want. Praise the name of God. There is a place we call the inner chambers. So for you to have an understanding with God where you can ask him anything, you have to be in the inner chambers. And what brings you in the inner chambers is the relationship you have with him. And how do you build the relationship with him? Lord, it's you who said, I will be the head and not the tail. Lord, it's you who said, whatever you started in my life, you are going to finish. God, it is you who said, I shall succeed in the city and succeed in the up country. Are you still in this place? Some are saying relationship. How strong is your relationship with God? Because before you even ask anything from God, there must be a strong relationship between you and God. Now watch this. Watch this. When I need something from her, when I need something from her, and there is a strong relationship, I don't need to struggle. Praise God. And if there is a relationship, she should be knowing what I need even before I ask. That is how God works too. It's not just God, give me, God, do this, this, this to me. No, there must be a strong relationship between you and God. Someone say amen. Ask your brother, your sister, how is your relationship with God? Someone say amen. For God to answer your prayers, for God to do that what you want him to do, there must be a strong relationship between you and him. Because it is the relationship here that introduces you into the doing of the responsibility. Someone say responsibility. Say responsibility. A lady can love you when you are responsible. A man can love you when you are responsible. Praise God. The boys of nowadays, they want to chase the ladies. Eh? Ladies want to chase the boys. The moment a responsibility comes in, they disappear in the forest because they cannot carry out and pass the test of responsibility. You are not saying amen. Because you are not responsible. Yeah? You want it the easy way. The easy way. And now, this is my sermon. I want to preach to you now. Jesus in Matthew, he asks, Father, why have thou forsaken me? Now watch this. You can only ask such a question if there is a relationship. You are not talking to me. Praise God. What did Jesus say? Jesus say, Father, why have thou forsaken me? Praise God. Now, wait a minute. Why do bad things happen to good people? Because in the book of Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 1, why do the ways of the wicked prosper? Now, it is only when you understand that you have a God when you can ask. Because if you don't know there is a God, you can't even ask. You are not talking to me. Praise God. For you to ask, there must be an understanding that there is a God in heaven. Have you ever walked in a meeting whereby the anointing of God is too heavy on the ground? People are praying, people are crying tears, but we have people are standing and watching like this. And you wonder what is the problem with these people. The problem is simple. They don't have a relationship with God. People who walk in the meeting, they begin to pray. They begin to cry tears. It is happening because there is a strong relationship between them and their God. So for you to ask, there must be a strong relationship between you and God.